Hi there, welcome to this Google Colab tutorial. Google Colab is a free cloud server unlike the Jupyter Notebook. We have explained about the Google Colab in the previous video. One of the perks of using Google Colab is data visualization. So today, what we're going to do is display a double bar graph of our data stored in an Excel sheet for analysis. This data that we're using is about the population of Bhutan in 2017 that is stored in an Excel sheet. First of all, we need to import Panda library for analyzing the data as well as manipulating it. Also, we need to import files from google.colab so that we can access the data files from the current working system. So let's run it. We use files.upload method to enable us to upload the Excel file from the local drive and save it as uploaded. It will prompt you to select the file, click on choose files, then select and upload the file. Wait for the file to be 100% uploaded. You should see the name of the file once the Colab has uploaded it. You see, files.upload method returns a dictionary of the files which were uploaded. The dictionary is keyed by the file name. The value is the data which was uploaded. Here we can get the name of the file uploaded with its length, but you can skip it if you don't want it. Now we have to import IO to import it into a data frame. We have to make sure that the file name matches the name of the uploaded file. The printf will let us print the content of the file. We can see all the data from the Excel sheet printed here. The df.columns will allow us to display the header of the columns of the table from the data file. Now that we are done with displaying the data, in order to plot the double bar graph, we have to import byplot from matplotlib library as well as import numpy, which will be used later. So now what we have to do is initialize the variable that will store the data. Initialize the first variable as label, which will store the name of the zonka. The second variable as men underscore no, which will store the number of men, and the third variable as women underscore no, which will store the number of women from the Excel file. Let's initialize variable x. It is a combination of two methods. This one, it returns number of items. In this particular case, it is 20, since there is 20 zonkaks. And this method, since it accepts only one parameter, it indicates the stopping point. It starts from 0 and ends at 19. This indicates the width of the bars. This following function returns a tuple containing a figure and axis object. Thus, when using this, you unpack these tuples into variables fig and x. This parameter fig size determines the size of the plotted bar graph with the length 10 and the width 25. The following lines makes a bar plot for each number of males and number of females for each zonka. Usually, the x.bar method accepts 3 parameters. However, here it has 4 parameters. This shows the x coordinates. Men underscore no denotes the height of the bar. This gives the width of the bar. And the label denotes the different gender. As for this, it provides the label for y-axis as the number of people. This provides the label for x-axis as zonkak. And this says the title of the bar graph as population of Bhutan 2017. The following two lines sets the position and the label of each of the different zonkaks. With the help of the parameters rotation, the label of each zonkak can be tilted at 45 degrees. We have set the legend method, which has enabled us to manipulate the font size of this scale. These following functions is for attaching the text label automatically above each bar displaying its height. So we get the height of the bar with this. In order to annotate each of the text labels, ax.annotate method is used. It accepts the following parameters. This is the value to be annotated. XY gives coordinate of XY to annotate. XYText gives the XY point to place the text at. Textcode shows that the text should be at offset point. While HA will consider the horizontal alignment, BA considers the vertical alignment. The function autolabel is called for each of the bars for male and female. We can automatically adjust support params so that the plot fits into the figure area using this. Now this method is used so that we can display figure as a whole. As you can see, this is one of the methods we can do data visualization using Python in Google Colab. Here we can see clearly the varying number of males and females from each song cox. This is one of the many ways we can do data visualization using Python in Google Colab.